Coach, we are about 15 miles west of downtown Phoenix at State Farm Stadium in Glendale, Arizona. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the San Francisco 49ers and the Arizona Cardinals. The calendar has turned to December, and we're in the home stretch now as we're underway in Week 13. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Carry down. This is Johnson. And he'll get this one up to the 26. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL, so when they're that high power, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored gives yourself, you give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
On second down, here's Rosen. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete. They got pressure there and only rushing three.
And there's a defensive coordinator right now who is celebrating not just getting home with three there, but realizing if that's the type of pressure he can get in the entire game, then his pass defense is going to be excellent. You're dropping eight. Where are you going to go with the football?
Gone!
And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. And a movement there coming from the middle of the line.
And you understand he wants to get off the ball quickly, but the ball's right in front of him. He has to watch it move first.
From the gun on third down, it's Rosen. Eluding the pressure right. Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Thrown back across his body. He's picked off at his own 46. And he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive. First interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
Now let's go. Green 39. Green 39.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 28. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line. Unfortunately for him, if last week was any indication, we knew a pick was coming at some point. Last week it was interception after interception, and here we go again.
We actually quit counting last week at a certain point because I thought I was going to run out of fingers, all right, because I'm not all that skilled as a mathematician. But you're right, it felt like a matter of time, and you've got to think the guys on defense, they couldn't wait for this opportunity after what they saw on tape.
Dumping it off for Johnson. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down.
Detroit!
They'll look to throw on first down to Josh Rosen. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
All right, here we go. Blue 90! Blue 90!
Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? Jumpy on the right side of the line.
Sometimes when you're on the end, a little bit farther away from the ball, any type of movement will get you to jump, and that's exactly what happened there.
So the penalty certainly helps them out as they come up on second and five.
Gone, 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 gone.
Following the penalty, it's Johnson. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. His first catch, good for 9 and a first down.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him, and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out, to the sideline, and make a catch.
On first down, it's Rosen. He's going to let this one go deep. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess. They work again from the 38 on second and 10. On play action, Rosen. Flush to his right. His throw incomplete. Charles, he doesn't seem to be particularly in tune with his receivers, just 2 for 7 throwing the football, but he did seem really locked in before the game.
Yeah, and that has to do with receivers sometimes. Sometimes the defenders knock them off their routes, and they're usually pretty precise. 1, 2, 3, cut, ball's out of his hands to the receiver. In this case, might be off by a half step either way. They've got to find a way to get back in sync.
Third down, Rosen. And able to find Kirk complete. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Throw right side, going to be caught by Seals Jones. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. Ricky Seals Jones with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Cardinals have taken the early lead. Extra point right down the middle, and it's now a 7-0 game. Pinheiro now to kick this one away. Here's Dante Pettis on the return. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And last time, one play, interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Back to throw. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. A good job defensively to hold that to 4 yards, and now it's third down.
But it's tough to be a defender in today's NFL because there's so many things to account for in today's passing game, including the back sneaking out of the backfield. Not quite as bad as a turkey bowl where you have that center eligible stuff, but still a lot of guys to account for.
Set up a throw. Open man, Smith-Schuster, it's complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. First time that they've called his number tonight, and it gets him a first down. Carry for Smith, and he's going to take this one down inside the 45. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Smith, and he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. Only 3 there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
2nd and 1 is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, "Are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down." They love being physical.
Tackle made there by Buda Baker.
On that play, it was the defensive front that won the battle. They out-leveraged the offensive line, got into the backfield, and held them to no gain.
Now let's go!
Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. And this one's incomplete.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground incomplete.
Here comes the 7th play now of this drive, as this is 3rd and 10. Look to throw. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
And I tell you what, he got it from 58. That had lots of leg behind it. These kickers now, it's like we take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted. But I have a theory about it. You want to hear it?
Yep.
They are more athletic now than ever before. Talk about kickers. Trace their backgrounds, trace their histories. You'll find that they were big-time athletes all along, but their kicking was so prevalent that we made them specialists. Well,
and now those 50-plus yarders seem easy for some reason. Rosen and the Cardinals take over with a 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Detroit! Detroit! All right, now, lucky 56! Lucky 56! All right, now, lucky 56! Lucky 56!
Rosen on 1st and 10, looking deep downfield. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line. You don't see this often. A quarterback of his caliber, 2 first-half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is his horoscope off? His biorhythms? What is it?
You went horoscope on us, David.
Well, I was thinking maybe REM sleep was off. I'm trying to come up with something.
Anything, right?
There's the Washington Husky. It's Dante Pettis. And a nice gain of 21 yards. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. Gets this one left side to Pettis. So a good spin move there before he's taken down. A nice little gain. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable 2nd and 1. On the carry, this is Scott. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. Only a gain of a yard, but that's all they needed, as that's going to move the chains.
2nd and 1, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10.
Let's go! 3-19! 3-19! Gone, gone! Gone, gone!
Now on 1st down, he'll drop to throw it. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Robert Kendiche in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year. So 2nd and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range.
Let's go.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. It's an 8-yard pickup, and they're going to face an uphill battle here on 3rd and long.
Gone, gone! Gone, gone!
Looking to throw. Hard throw, incomplete.
That's a good job there, creating the contact to force the incompletion. And now, since it's 4th down, that should set up a field goal situation.
And a nice sigh of relief defensively to be able to hold them to 3. And Gold is able to put it through. And they'll get it back within a point at 7-6. No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them. If they need him late in the game, his confidence should be sky high.
Fielded about a yard deep. So out now come the Cardinals. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. They begin the drive with Johnson. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Now Rosen to throw on 2nd down. Rolling to his right. Oh, he just needed to throw it away, but it...
No. up. I defeated my fears. Soaked the towel in my tears. So ahead of my time, what comes next to all my oldest ideas? I'm wiser than my... Chin check y'all in y'all beard. I'm willing to father my peers, all of my peers for all of my years. Out in the field, take a look at my shoes. Never had a thought that it might lose. Considering the cost, how to give them my dues. Never got a talk to a like you. I've been feeling like a king for months. We eat all the rich cuisine for lunch. All these wishing he was done. Oh, you tried it, that's a piece of gum. Nah, look at me, I'm the captain now. I'm a crew in this year. I be praying for y'all while I'm praying for y'all. I'm like a lot of abuse in this deer. I hate a dude with no plans. Now I'm usually getting near. Oh, my ex are her man. Cause I'm the mutant in here. We look good, just show us where the camera. Years ago, I had to up my standards. Make your missus Alabama. Turn it to my only private. Swear like she don't got the answers. Who's the boss? I feel like Tony Danza. Walk up in there like I got the swag. Wakanda swagger, I'm the blackest panther. Wakanda, y'all are wasting y'all time. I spend it, but I ain't wasting a dime. Might do some favors, but I ain't breaking my spine.
Your girl has been calling for days. I get no different ways. That New Orleans parades. Yeah, we like, none of my people are patient. We look like we on a vacation. Get no invitation.
Y'all all with it and y'all talk a lot, but y'all ain't got the heart to do the mission. I'm hard-headed like the juggernaut, but there ain't nothing I can do to listen. I'm authentic and I walk around like I just ate, but let you do the dishes. I'm Clark Kent, but mix the Autobots and mix with everything that you've been missing. Please get back and don't get that involved. Freaking sick, I need a pad of walls. I'm the king, heavy crown, heavy rain, cat and dogs. Homie with me if you asking for it. There ain't much that he be asking for. He just wanna have a pedicon with a watch face with little dragon balls. Come on, look, you don't need me either. All I need is this. No coca ice, and I get oh so polite. You be the man of your city, I'll be the man of my country. You could be the man of your city, I'ma be the man of my country.
Your girl has been calling for days. I get it in all different ways. New Orleans parades, yeah, we like. None of my people are patient. We look like we on a vacation. Get no invitation. Yeah, we like. Your girl has been calling for days. I get it in all different ways. Ways. Yeah, I'm like. None of my patient. We look like we on a vacation.
Trying to move it up. It was like lemon in the morning. Skip to school, that's a truancy body. I made me some rats in the morning. I had me up by the morning. I had me some breaks by the morning. I had a sis by the morning. I got on a mean on the morning. The rats keep me up on the ocean.
We find ourselves at the home of the world's first retractable natural grass field as you get a look inside State Farm Stadium in Glendale. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the San Francisco 49ers and the Arizona Cardinals. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. To the 24. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. After the loss to start out, here's second and 11.
They'll set up to throw. Now they go screen. It's complete. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. He lost two there. And it's third down. And this opening drive not going to plan. This is now third and 13. To throw. And the pressure will bring him down here. The Cardinals get home for the sack.
They just gave up a sack there, and if I'm not mistaken, they gave up four last week, didn't they?
Yes. And just looking really porous, aren't they?
They really are, and I'm wondering if they're going to have to start thinking about keeping the tight end in, maybe a back, someone to help assist, because right now, the quarterback's been getting hit a lot in the last couple of games.
Raisin and the Cardinals take over with a first and 10 at the 45.
Detroit! Detroit! All right, here we go. 3-19!
They go play action here on first down. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off right around the 43. And the possession is theirs at their own 43-yard line.
Well, I get what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage, but instead he shifted the coverage also to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. They'll find Juju Smith-Schuster. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
Those are the kinds of plays right there that show you why he's the number three man in the NFL in terms of receiving yards.
Also tells you there's a full combination of what he's got going in his game. You name it, from route running to catching the football. That's why he's able to produce those types of numbers.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
All right, here we go.
He'll drop to throw. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And not much. Maybe a yard down to the 23.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That was a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short gain.
Second down, Scott, and able to get about three as he's taken down right at the 20. Good job there keeping him to a short game. Of course, he's coming off a really terrific performance, reigning NFC Defensive Player of the Week.
And I know people get caught up in, well, if you're the reigning Defensive Player of the Week, you must have made a bunch of spectacular plays. Like, you mixed in a few of those, but most of the plays are just like we saw there. Keep them to short gains, make the fundamental tackle.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Able to get there and pick it.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
They'll run for the first time with Johnson. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
On second down, Johnson. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line.
Only a yard on the pickup there, so it leaves them needing a conversion here on third and a tough nine. Josh Rosen. This one complete to Christian Kirk. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. A very solid gain of 27.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision. And receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
Now Rosen on first down. Got a man open. It's Ricky Seals-Jones. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
Detroit! Detroit! You got three.
Now a play fake here on first down. And he will find his man on the outside. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time, and a first down. That's the number two receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage, and tell you what, a few more plays like that, he won't be number two for long.
But that's what often happens when you have competitors running around the field. These guys know where they stand in relationship to yardage, totals, numbers, the whole deal. And let's face it, all of them, they all want to be number one.
He takes us down to about the 12 for a gain of three. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well. But when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Just a couple on the ground there, and that's going to bring up third and about six.
Early down stuff's to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
And now it's Rosen looking. And a quick throw here, that's complete. Ready to go now in the second quarter. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis. It's the Cardinals in possession of the football. They are, however, facing a fourth down situation. And the first play will be a field goal try. The kick by Pinheiro is good. And the Cardinals have the first points. It's 3-0. So still no touchdowns in the first half, but we do have some action on the scoreboard with the field goal.
So maybe now the mentality changes in this game, because anytime you can get to the red zone and if you don't come away with 6 points, you feel like it's a disappointment. In a game like this one, being able to kick field goals means you're right there, and then you're just looking for that big break to take you over the top.
Out on the field now, here come the 49ers. And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first two drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now, and I'm going to take it into the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do? Get it to their best player, right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, and try to move the football.
On first down, Scott. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
So that'll back him up five. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Throw right side, taken in by Pettis. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. That one goes for 24 yards.
Three,
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. To throw now on first down. Over the middle to Smith. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
They'll look to throw now on first down. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. So the pass incomplete in the end zone, but contact and pass interference.
And now where does the ball get placed?
At the 1 yard line.
1 yard line. They gave up excellent real estate on that one. That's going to work really, really well for the guys who threw it.
Trying to turn the corner, but they string him out and stop him at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. They come up here with another shot from the 6 yard line, and it's second and goal now.
Here we go now.
They'll give it to him up the middle. And they'll get him down here at about the 5 yard line. Call it a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal.
That run didn't get very far, and I think when you're looking at his dimensions, he's a little bit on the smaller side. He's counting on the big guys up front to escort him in, and they couldn't create any kind of space for him, could they?
Yeah, didn't get the push they needed. Now back to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion, kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you can go make a play on the football.
So three drives now for this offense, and that field goal gives them their first 3 points.
So if you're an offensive coordinator and you're averaging a point a drive, you're in the wrong line of work, aren't you? You got to find a way to unlock the key to these defenses and put some big points on the board.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Cardinal offense now making their way back out onto the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. They'll give him 8 on the play, and it'll make it second down. Here's a 2nd and 2 now from the 33. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that'll make it third down. They'll try and run for it. Here's Johnson, and he'll get this up only to about the 33. Just a 1 yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's fourth down.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bashed it.
Super toe.
Gone, gone!
back to throw now on second and 10. Over the middle, complete. That's Bishop. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. 13 yards on his first catch. It's a first down as well.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game, because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
Well, they don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway.
Set, blue, line it.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. He rifles one, it's intercepted. He's picked off at his own 46. And this one will be returned to right around the... yard line. A minute 59 to go in the first half. More from the desert after this. So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Detroit!
After the interception, here's Rosen. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he gets it down deep into San Francisco territory. That goes for a gain of 31.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that and have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the 5. They'll try and run. This is Johnson. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the 1. And now the 49ers signal for a timeout defensively, as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. He'll get it up the middle, and he will get into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Anthony Sherman, his second touchdown on the season. And the Cardinals are in for 6. And it is up. And it's good. That'll make our score 10-3 now. Pinheiro now to kick this one away. This is taken at the 3. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. On the stop, Breland speaks.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You mean, or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
They'll set up a throw. And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number 1.
Another dangerous throw there, partner. I mean, he's already thrown 2 interceptions here in the first half. I don't know if you want to keep throwing up 50-50 balls and you've had that kind of lack of success.
Yeah, absolutely. Very well could have been a 3rd interception in half number 1.
Back to throw.
Open man, Smith-Schuster, it's complete. 23 yards on the play. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. They'll drop the throw. And he fires one incomplete. Juju Smith-Schuster, the intended receiver that time. And it's third down.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back in pass rush. They've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
The Niners on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This will be third and six.
Now let's go. Green, 39.
He'll look to throw. Going to throw right side here. Complete. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. This offense right, finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. Pressure comes and the Cardinals bring him down. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. He made his first, this from 47 yards out. And Gold is able to put it through. So we reach halftime here in Glendale with the Cardinals on top. As now we send you out to Orlando and hook back up with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Gold now out to kick it away. This will be fielded at the 6. And a very good return, but a penalty marker is down. I'm not sure what this is going to be. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
They'll look to throw on first down with Josh Rosen. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. This drive starting off on the right foot, 18 yards.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Second down, here's Rosen. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Crawford. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. A really nice gain of 25 yards. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's going to get him about 3 yards closer. He's down to about the 2.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
They'll run it with Johnson. And this is not going to do it as he stopped at the 2-yard line. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a 3rd and goal. The Cardinals on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and goal. They come out here in the eye. They'll try to run it in. Johnson. And he gets halfway there, down to the 1 yard line. Only a yard that time, so now a decision to be made here on fourth and goal. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
The offense is staying out there. Here we go on fourth and goal from the one. And he didn't get there. Knocked backwards to the 2 yard line. Johnson kept out of the end zone on fourth down, and his 49er defense stands tall down near the goal line. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down.
Here we go now. Green 39. Green.
They'll run on first down. Scott. And he was very fortunate there to get out of his end zone. He maybe got back to the 2 yard line. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56. Now let's go. Blue 90. Blue 90.
Back to throw now in his own end zone. He's going to fire one. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off by DJ Swearinger. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They'll try to get the offense going with Johnson. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Credit the tackle there to Aaron Lynch. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
That's going to be caught. Touchdown, Cardinals. Christian Kirk, his ninth touchdown of the season. And the Cardinals turning that interception into a touchdown. Extra point safely through. And that pushes the lead up to 11. Pinheiro now to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The 49ers offense making its way back out there.
No. Check. Patriot. No. Check. Patriot.
On first down, Scott. And he'll get this one up to the 26. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making
it. He's got a man complete. And out across midfield down to the 45. Give him 30 yards there. Well, even after all those interceptions, he's not deterred, still confident to go deep at work there.
I think all the old rules about playing that position still apply. If things go wrong, you still act like you're the best.
The Cards get to him here. He's brought down for a sack.
I know there'll be a little bit of criticism there because they went right back to the air after the huge pickup and end up getting sacked. That's often a play that you make. You feel like you've got momentum on your side.
Unfortunately, the O-line failed to hold up to try to keep that momentum going. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down.
Here we go now. Green 39.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. They showed off a nice juke of the defender before the next wave could bring him down. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and all of a sudden here, it's third down. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. They'll look to throw. Throw left side, complete to Smith-Schuster. It's a gain of 17, and it'll give them a first down. This quarterback now 11 of 17 passing thus far. He's got his guys a first and 10.
All right, here we go. Blue 90. Detroit.
They'll look to throw here. And he's got his man on the out route.
And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. That throw good for four. It's second down. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. Looking to throw. That is caught inside the five. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. A good pick up there of 20 yards. Here we go now with Smith. They're able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop him right around the one.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Going to get it running right, and he'll take this into the end zone for a San Francisco touchdown. A great play there with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year, and the 49ers have cut it back within a score. Now the 49ers electing to leave the offense out there and go for two. Toss coming right side. That's Scott. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the six. Gold now out to kick it away. This is taken at the three. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
And they'll start the drive on the ground with Johnson. And now running right through it and able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. 31 yards there and a first down.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there. And on that play, I saw a defense staying in base, not taking a chance, not blitzing in a situation where they absolutely need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it or not thinking it through.
If you do blitz, do you have to be careful about where you're coming from, or are you just coming from all angles?
You have to be careful about where you're coming from, obviously. But at this stage, you have to take a few chances as well.
Now Rosen looking to throw. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. No gain there on the completion, second and 10.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained. So they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly.
Here we go now.
They go play action. It's Rosen. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Crawford. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. A good pick up there. 26 yards. First down carry here for Johnson. And they'll lose yardage here. They go backwards to the 13-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Sometimes play calls boil down to philosophy. You know you're facing one of the top 10 units against the run in the NFL. So do you decide to keep smashing against them, or do you decide to throw the ball here?
They go to Johnson again, and he'll fight his way down right around the 12. 1 yard, the official pickup there, so it's going to set up third and 9.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
The Cardinals on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is third and nine. From the gun, it's Rosen. Oh, it's a touchdown if he holds on. Instead, it's fourth. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. The kick by Pinheiro is good. And that'll push the lead up to eight. Now from a defensive perspective, though, I think maybe they're saying, hey, we did what we needed to do, kept this a one-score game.
Yeah, without a doubt, because they were able to bleed some time off the clock, right? Put themselves in a good position. But it's not out of reach yet, okay? Being able to hold them to a field goal means that they do have a chance to come back and win this game.
Good starting field position for the 49ers as they have it first and 10.
All right, here we go. Blue Niner!
They'll run with Scott. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight. He has just been completely taken out of this game. We're in the fourth quarter. He's single digits in the rushing department.
And I know we look at him because the numbers do go to his production, but how about the guys blocking for him? They don't just have his number as a ball carrier. They've got the number of the offensive line and the other guys because they're getting to him before he can get started.
Here's Scott. He had a great move, but he'll still be stopped shy of midfield. Good work to pick up 7 yards there. That gets him into a third and one situation. Here comes a big one as this crowd gets up making some noise. It's third and short. They're going to look to throw. Oh, that one sailed a bit, but the catch is still made. His fifth catch tonight, and it's good for a first down. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
They'll run on first down. Scott. There he goes, right side. Touchdown, 49ers. A great effort there. His second touchdown of the night. And the 49ers move back within a couple of the lead. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
And a failure to convert and tie the game. Now the pressure shifts back to the defense.
But I think it was the right play. I think it was the right call to try and tie the game there. Kick an extra point, you're still down one. What's the sense? I like what they did.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Cardinals offense now works their way back onto the field. They're holding on right now to that slim advantage in a one-score game. And you hear a lot about two-minute offense and four-minute offense. Obviously, the four-minute offense applies here. How do they run that effectively?
Yeah, really what the four-minute offense is you're just trying to grind the clock. So you want consistent gains, steady gains. Doesn't have to be big plays, but it has to be plays that gets first downs and keeps the ball away from your opponent.
But certainly throwing the ball is in the mix here.
It certainly is. Just make sure that you're careful with it. And again, get those first downs, keep possession of the football.
Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10.
Gone! All right, now, lucky 56, lucky 56.
second and 10 now. It's Rosen. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And this drive will start on the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line.
Well, partner, here's where team football gets tested a little bit, because I know the defensive guys were over there chilling on the sidelines, and all of a sudden, they heard the sudden change call, because that fumble puts them right back on the field, and they've got to go out and finish the game now themselves.
Absolutely. Nursing that slim lead here in the fourth, a costly turnover. And they go the wrong way here. Knocked back to the 20. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
So the myth has been shattered. Every cornerback in the league is not just a cover corner. Some of them will stick their nose in there and make plays, exactly as we just saw there. A big loss suffered by the offense after that nice tackle.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. Give him 8 on the play, and that's going to lead to a third down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They've become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
As big of a play as we've had in this one so far. This is 3rd and 3.
Set! Green 39! Green 39!
Now Scott. And they'll go backwards here, losing yardage to the 14. He lost 2, and it brings up 4th. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first time out. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the 2-minute warning. So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. And Gold is able to put it through. And with that, they have taken the lead by a point here in the 4th. So the drive here ends with a field goal. It does give them the lead, but this one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on your defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it and happy to be out there trying to do so. But I know as a former player, in the back of their mind, they're thinking, why don't you score the touchdown and seal this thing?
The Cardinal offense here ready to take over. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though? When they only gave up the field goal, and they were able to trot back out on the field and start this drive, a little more pep in their step because it didn't cost their team a touchdown. But they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
The coach will just be relieved, though, if they recoup with a score here, right?
I think coach would be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield and punch in the end zone without turning it over.
Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. Well, we had a number of good games in the afternoon sessions, but this Sunday nighter might top them all. So we come up here on 1st and 10.
Lucky 56.
Out of the gun. Here's Josh Rosen. Now a desperation throw deep downfield, and that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on 1st down.
Detroit! Detroit!
The busy night continues for Johnson. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. It's a good gain of 11, sets him up 1st and goal. And now the 49ers signal for a timeout defensively. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the 1st down. And the question now, how do they want to work the clock here on 1st and goal? A field goal would give them the late lead. Again, it's Johnson. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be 2nd and goal.
Well, they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
They get it to him running left. And he'll take this one down inside the 5 to the 3. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
On third down, Johnson. And he is in for 6. Touchdown, Cardinals. David Johnson in the final minute. And the Cardinals have taken the lead here in the 4th. Now Rosen will lead him up here to go for 2.
All right, here we go.
Throwing now is Rosen. Escaping the pressure right. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Should have been picked. Probably doesn't matter on a 2-point conversion. But still, as a former DB, you want to grab that ball when you can, don't you?
You certainly do. And don't say it, because I know you're thinking it. Don't say it.
What am I thinking?
You know what I know what you're thinking. Well, if he had hands, he'd be playing on offense.
Yeah, that's true. You've said that before. The San Francisco offense getting their last-minute instructions before they take over here. One possession game, time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be somewhat relaxed. And I know that's counterintuitive because this is a pressure situation. But this is Friday practice every week of the season. You go over this situation, having to go downfield, limited timeouts, got to get out of bounds and keep the drive going and set yourself up. Defensively, you can't just lay back and let them do whatever they want. So it is a cat and mouse deal here. How much pressure will the defense bring and how much pressure can the offense handle?
We're going to find out. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. They call his number again. It's his 6th catch and a 1st down.
All right, they picked up yardage, but they've got to get up to the line of scrimmage and spike it. They've got one timeout left. Want to save it.
He's going to let it flop. It's caught inside the 25. And he's across for the touchdown, and it's likely the game winner here in the closing stages. Might be seeing that one on the highlight shows tonight. The home run ball here in the 4th quarter to take the lead.
There's nothing like being aggressive, preaching that to your team, and then following through all the way through. Go ahead and throw one more up there. Why not?
Been a great game, and we are not done yet. Gold able to tack on the extra point. And it would appear, barring some late heroics, they're going to get out of here with a come-from-behind victory. Gold now out to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. So you're right there, but obviously the clock is not your friend. How do you handle this situation?
You're thinking 2 plays. One, to get yourself in position for the second one, whether you're able to get into field goal range or you have to try another deep pass, another Hail Mary. But you're trying to get the first one to a receiver, get out of bounds, and give yourself a chance to set things up for an easier shot at it.
We'll see if they can do it. Might be easier said than done. And he can't hang on to it. That would have sealed him. Instead, 2nd down. So after all of this, it comes down to 1 final play.
And just think of what it's going to be, because from this distance, you've got to be prepared for everything. Hook and laterals, tip balls,
Patrick,
a lot of laterals after a catch. Just got to be prepared, stay on your feet defensively, and tackle someone.
One final shot here for Rosen. Now a desperation throw deep down, and that's caught inside the 35. At the beginning of the year, they said we want to win 9 games. They just got that 9th win.
And congratulations to them. That's fantastic. Team goal met, and they still have opportunity to go above that number.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we say good night from Glendale.